the commitment of Dufresne Manufacturing to building up a more vibrant business community in our local area truly cannot be understated. Dufresne Manufacturing is an example of a community builder, a community leader, and we as a business community thank you. On behalf of the VHEDC Board of Directors, congratulations to you, employees of Dufresne Manufacturing, for your engagement in the Baldrige journey and the road you continue to travel. We are thrilled to journey with you as the road you stride toward is a very bright one.
And when he talked about what you have done, it wasn't pride in his business, it was pride in the people that he was working with. It came through from the moment he came to our city council meeting and we gave him a proclamation there at that time. The recession, that had to be an unbelievable obstacle. The sacrifices you made, and Bob referred to them at our city council meeting, the sacrifices you made to keep the business moving ahead. Thank you. On behalf of the city of Vadnais Heights, thank you to what you've done.
And be it further proclaimed that we declare today, May 1st, 2015, will forever be known as Dufresne Manufacturing Day in Ramsey County.
It's all about celebrating this journey that Dufresne's been on, and it's been for quite a while, and it's not going to end. They're going to continue the journey. But this was the time when they won the award, the Penn Award, first manufacturing company ever.
We're not supposed to have favorites, but we do. And this, of course, did not have any influence on your award. That is a high integrity process, but there is no doubt that working with Dufresne is one of the highlights of our experience in Penn. You have become an extension of our family. So you are in very elite company. This is hard work and it's very transparent. And I think the very transparent nature of this work, you kind of throw open your doors for organizations to see what you're doing, is maybe something not all organizations are willing to do. And yet here you are saying, this is what we do, we believe in ourselves, this is the good work that we're at, and we're willing to share it. So whether you realize it or not, you have now become role models. All of you and the work that you do are role models for other organizations, particularly manufacturing in the state of Minnesota. Your focus on human development is second to none. And I said to Chris when I saw her, I said, Chris, we've got something really big here. Other organizations are going to be coming to you to find out what you are doing. You are part of a national movement to help organizations get better.
How are you feeling?
I'm feeling honored and blessed to be here. The people that represent Dufresne Manufacturing are just the greatest.
He is a visionary leader. He is very committed to his people. We call them members, not employees. He is very people oriented. I've never worked for a company like Dufresne Manufacturing, and this is where I will retire.
I call myself a newbie at Dufresne. I've been there about a year and a half, and I remember when I was interviewed and I was asked, why Dufresne? Why would you come to Dufresne? And I said, because I saw a small company doing big things.
We started in 1991. In Shoreview for a couple years, then we moved to Vadnais Heights. Next year we're going on our 25th year. We're in precision metal manufacturing, is how we started. We hit a transition point in 2008 in the recession period. It was a difficult spot for us because it brought us to our knees and we had to downsize quite a bit. We're looking for a cure for this recession to prepare the company to be financially stronger, and have more job security for our employees. We pulled in a consultant from the outside, Nancy Holdren, to do the training on it. We trained the senior leaders at Dufresne in the framework and criteria. It took weeks to learn it. And from that point on, we just started to develop a leadership system, and we just kept on training more people all along to this framework, this model that looks at your strategic planning, looks at your leadership, it looks at your customers, it looks how your knowledge in measuring the data within the company, it looks at your operations that you've got going on, it looks at your human resource, and finally, you have to have the results. And that's what the evaluators look at when they come in, which was in October, They did 160 interviews. They interviewed everybody in the facility more than once. And that's where we ended up getting this high score. And that's where they discovered three key processes, systems inside that ended up being best in practice.
PEN, so the Performance Excellence Network, is really many volunteers, business people that act as volunteers to go out and evaluate the company. So it's one thing to fill out a 50-page application and say, we could do this. It's another thing for the evaluators to come into your business world and speak to every one of your employees and say, okay, tell us what you do. And they talk to us about what they saw. And what they delivered for you at that time is, it's called OFIs, Opportunities for Improvement. And which is really wonderful for an organization because, I mean, it can be real humbling too. You might think, oh, we're really great at this, and you find out, oh, you could maybe improve a little bit more. But that's a beautiful thing, and that's part of my role as the Baldrige Program Facilitator to really help us as we move forward, track the history, because we're going to apply again in the next year, year and a half. So we know we're going to keep up going up the ladder.
So Baldrige was started by President Reagan back in 25 years ago. He wanted to make manufacturing companies more competitive, so he hired Malcolm Baldrige to develop his framework. So he interviewed hundreds and hundreds of customers, clients out there, and looked for the criteria that made a very good manufacturing company. Over the last 25 years, it's gotten better and better, tougher and tougher, and now the states have adopted it. So this is the Minnesota Excellence Award based on the Baldrige framework that we were awarded. Since 2007, our employees have turned in 16,000 improvement ideas. 16,000 improvement ideas. The engagement, and when I interview those people, 7 out of 10 reasons why they look to make changes for the future for Dufresne is always for somebody else. It's not for themselves, it's not to make their job better, it's for someone else.
I do present this to you guys for all the hard work. You guys are in our office in manufacturing and engineering, customer service. You touch all the processes, you make all the processes. And all these words are for you guys out there too.
So that's just proof of the engagement and what you need in order to be the best, in order to be recognized at this level in world-class manufacturing.